Hi there, and thank you so much for joining today's webinar. Today, we've teamed up with the higher education team at salesforce.org to bring you the Higher Education Summit From Your Couch, Advancement and Alumni Engagement webinar. My name is Taylor Bug, and I'm the marketing coordinator here at Cloud for Good. Your lines are muted today, so I encourage you to submit any and all of your questions using the Q&A button on your screen. So today, we're gonna have speakers from both salesforce.org and Cloud for Good. But you may be wondering, who is Cloud for Good and how do they work with salesforce.org? One of the best parts of Salesforce is its ecosystem of partners, and we all have a unique role. Salesforce's role is to provide you an integrated CRM platform that gives all departments across your campus a shared view of every student, from prospective students in early recruiting stages all the way to alumni as active donors. Jim from salesforce.org will be sharing more about this shortly. Because Salesforce is so flexible and doesn't force you to change your business processes when you implement it, Cloud for Good's role is to help you map out those processes and configure the Salesforce instance to meet your unique requirements. We are an implementation partner, but not just any implementation partner. We are the 2019 Salesforce.org Nonprofit Partner of the Year. Cloud for Good was founded in 2010, and since then we've grown to over 80 employees across the US and Canada. Nearly everyone has experience working with nonprofits and higher education institutions. Our goodies have real-world experience, extensive Salesforce knowledge, and cross-cloud experience to deliver the best possible results. As a team, we have hundreds of Salesforce certifications and thousands of Trailhead badges collectively, covering everything from Education Cloud to Pardot to Marketing Cloud. Together, we've completed over 2,000 Salesforce implementations, and we're the very first partner to earn the Advancement in Alumni Specialization. Throughout the course of this webinar, you're going to learn more about the history of the Higher Education Summit, Advancement in Alumni Engagement sessions that we're most excited to see, and how to optimize your time at this event, followed by a Q&A with our panelists, so don't forget to submit all of your questions using the Q&A button on your screen. I am absolutely thrilled to introduce today's amazing subject matter experts. Doug is the Vice President of Industry Advisors and Advancement Impact at Salesforce.org. Jim is a Senior Account Executive for Higher Education at Salesforce.org. Kristen is our Partner Alliances Manager here at Cloud for Good. And as I mentioned before, I'm Taylor, the Marketing Coordinator. And with that, Jim, do you wanna tell us a little bit more information about the Salesforce Education Cloud?
Yeah, thank you very much. You can go ahead and advance to the next slide. Hi, so my name is Jim Worthington. I'm an account executive that handles Missouri, Arkansas, and Louisiana for Salesforce.org. And I want to tell you a little bit more about Salesforce.org and what we do and how we help our partners. Salesforce.org is focused on combining the power of student-centric technology with workforce development and community resources needed to maximize every student's potential. It is the world's number one CRM, and 96% of the most innovative schools use and trust Salesforce to drive student engagement across the entire life cycle. We're committed to empowering those around us to drive change through our powerful community of higher ed customers and partners, and this includes our now 40,000 member strong online community, the Power of Us Hub, as well as our fellow employees. On top of that, we also invest in getting getting students school, tech, and workforce ready through our Future Ready grants. Go ahead and go to the next slide, please. So with CRM, institutions can create a 360-degree view of their students and constituents by integrating that data across student information systems, learning management systems, financial aid, and more. And what this will do for you is it helps create a full 360-degree view of every constituent across the entire life cycle. With Salesforce, you're able to eliminate all those data silos and bring all your data together. Now, imagine if you could get a 360-degree view of each and every constituent all in one place. Well, with Salesforce, you can. You increase collaboration across campus and you break down those silos. You're able to proactively guide constituents to success with real-time analytics, AI, personalized marketing journeys, and much, much more. You're able to leverage the latest higher ed innovation with automatic updates delivered in the cloud. Next slide, please. So at Salesforce, we've invested heavily on helping institutions become what we call a connected campus with our education cloud. And that is a single set of solutions designed to help you drive student success across the lifecycle from prospect into what we'll be talking about today, alum. The platform provides the solutions to turn that into actionable data so you can recruit the right students and make smarter admissions decisions, to give every student the personalized support they need, and then to better connect with alumni and donors, and then, you know what, to exceed your fundraising goals. So let's take a look, or next slide, please. Sorry about that. So let's take a look, though, at the rising at those personalized experiences. You know, today's students and lifelong learners, they expect personalized communications. You know, we recently did a survey of over 650 students globally, and 78% of them said that personalized messages convey that their university cares about their success. Today's learners, they don't want to feel like a number, just in the crowd. They want to be fully seen as individuals that the university knows and really truly cares about. And so with that, they are also looking for a strong sense of belonging. You know, from the moment a student expresses their interest in an institution to the day that they graduate and they become alumni, they want to feel that they are part of that connected community. And it's those connections that help institutions develop stronger relationships with students even when they leave campus and become alumni. So next slide. All right. Thank you very much. And with that, I'm going to pass it over to Kristen.
Cool. Thank you, Jim. Yep. Hi, guys. I am Kristen. I'm a Partner Alliances Manager at Cloud for Good, which means I spend my days working with the Salesforce team and then all of the great AppExchange partners that we work with as well. I've been around in the ecosystem for a couple years, and I thought it would be important to share some of the history of Education Cloud to help you understand why it's going to be so worthwhile to attend the Higher Ed Summit. Okay, so the Higher Ed Education Data Architecture, or EDA as we call it, it started as an initiative between schools to share technology that was already developed, where I've already put in the work or the time investment. Why not share it with another school and save you time and money? There has always been a lot of pride within EDA that it was community driven from the beginning. Okay. And the same community that developed that actual data architecture also had a real hand in creating the Higher Ed Summit itself. And I think what you're going to see is that community just really shines through in every aspect of these events. So if you look at this kind of timeline up here at the top, way back in 2013, after Dreamforce, Colleen Whalen, she used to be at Yale University at the time, she kind of had this idea and she pitched it to the Salesforce.org leaders and said, what if we did like a little mini Dreamforce that was completely focused on higher ed? And she said she'd be willing to host it at Yale. So they did, and it was a huge success. And what happened is all these other leaders at different schools said, well, we'd like to do that too and do it in our geographic areas. So the official Higher Ed Summit was born in 2014, and you can see every year it's actually still hosted at a school, which again, it's just that community of customers being able to share. I was thinking about this and thinking about how much it's going to change this year with everything that's going on. And I was thinking back to just the logistics of the event. So the first year that I presented at Higher Ed Summit was somewhere in the middle there. It was actually at Tulane University. And I remember presenting in a hallway with a microphone talking about best practices to integrate Salesforce to SIS applications. And then I was thinking about last year, I watched Corey Snow. I've got some of the community champions down there at the bottom. Corey used to be at Harvard. He's now actually at Salesforce.org. But I watched Corey present with our team. They were talking about how research and development departments are using Salesforce successfully. And that was a silent disco. So to look at people presenting and not hear any words being spoken, it was really interesting. And now this year, we're going to be completely virtual, but I've got a sneak peek of the platform that this is going to be on, and it's going to be fantastic. There are collaboration tools that are built into this. It's going to be a much different feel than just like a go-to meeting where you're able to chat. So I'm excited to see the technology evolve again, even this year. And I was also thinking about the content of the sessions, right? So like in the first couple of years, there weren't really tracks. This year, there's going to be 5 tracks for everyone to choose from. So it's not even just about attending it and hearing from other schools. It's departmentally, right? As alumni, you're going to be able to see how other people are engaging with alumni. How are we handling donors? How are we handling volunteers? So you're going to hear directly from those other schools that have already solved those departmental challenges and hear their solutions. And the last thing I was just kind of thinking about with the community is the annual summit awards. Each year there are schools and people nominated for various awards. And there are things like community champion or who had the most innovative solution, right? And in the beginning, those tended to be these traditional student, larger schools where they had like either a dedicated Salesforce admin or even a team of admins. And when I looked at the nominees for this year, there are K-12 public schools, there are community colleges, there are new names being added in the community champions. It just really shows how much the education cloud community has expanded and how you're going to see that kind of shine through in this year's event. So I'm really excited about it this year. I hope you guys will carve out the time to attend this. And Doug's going to share a little bit more with you about the actual sessions that you'll be interested in.
Yeah, thank you so much, Kristen. Doug Barrow here. You can see by my background, I'm not in my home office today. I decided to get a bit of a head start on the holiday weekend. So I'm in northern Michigan, excited to be here and express really the truly dynamic environment we've created for this year. You know, Higher Ed Summit's always been my favorite. I've been to 6 of them. And I'd be remiss, Kristen, not to mention the one at Wayne State in my home state of Michigan, led by Kathy Lukeman. There's some debate if that was the first or Yale, but we're delighted to move to this new format. And I'll just say that Salesforce is putting the full weight of our innovation and our organization behind that. So it's a can't miss event. It's not just another recording that you can watch later on. It's something you're going to want to go to. So let's hit the next slide and just go a little bit deeper. I'll hit a few key points and then we'll talk about the advancement related sessions that I think will be of most interest to you. So I'm not going to read the slide to you because you can do that, but I will say that, you know, this is a great opportunity to really learn about what others are doing. Whether you're an advancement development office, alumni relations, or a completely different office, you're going to hear of innovative stories. Seeing those solutions in action, you know, many of our presenters, our customers who lead the vast majority of the presentations will be doing a demo of their live environment. So that's always a little fun to throw a live demo in there, but to see that in action, as well as our exceptional solution engineering team will be highlighting some innovative new solutions that we're bringing to market. You know, I think to me, hearing that impact directly, you know, Jason Long at Western Michigan University and talks about how they went through immense change and really the technology was the easy part. But reorienting that organization to be more donor-centric was the outcome of that. And the impact that they're having on students at Western Michigan University is transformational. There's also an opportunity for a live virtual exhibition hall, which is totally innovative and totally cool, and an opportunity to go into one-on-one. And then, of course, you know, something that's on everyone's mind is, how do you prepare for a post-COVID world where being virtual is just part of our lives and really seeing how Salesforce can help to facilitate that? So these are just a few reasons to attend. There's many more. The happy hours and the parties won't be there, but maybe we can bring some of that virtual flavor afterwards. We'll see. To get into more specifically the next slide, the sessions that I'm excited about, those who were at Higher Ed Summit San Diego last year had an opportunity to hear from CASE. CASE is the industry organization for advancement. They do phenomenal work in terms of professional development and highlighting the needs of their constituencies, those who serve universities and in support of education. Last year, we talked about the alumni engagement metrics and a framework that they were working to drive around standardizing how universities measure their metrics, because I think it can be a little subjective. So they're going to come back again and share that survey, and we're delighted to have them. We're one of the few organizations that's actually a CASE educational partner. We're renewing that again this year. So we're excited about that that presentation and that relationship. We're also going to hear from Georgetown University, really how to organize alumni data for reporting. Many of you are familiar with our acquisition of MuleSoft 2 years ago now. Well, this organization, Georgetown, uses MuleSoft not just to integrate to their CRM across a myriad of sources, but they also have put the MuleSoft layer on top of it so that they can serve alumni data out to their constituents in a programmatic way. Tremendous innovation, solves a big problem of shipping CSV files and Excel files across campus and potential security risks that go along with that. I mentioned earlier Western Michigan University and my good friend Jason Long present really the lessons they learned from moving off of a legacy system. In their case, it was Millennium. They were ready for a new system transformation and went through a lightning fast 14 months, not recommended maybe to do all that they did, including marketing automation, a donor portal, and a call center, all in that time. But they'll share some lessons that I think you'll find tremendously valuable. The last two here, really, you know, our friends at Harvard Alumni, Kelly will be sharing really their vision, their strategy, how they're leveraging that dynamic content to send singular campaigns to improve their metrics versus sending a myriad of campaigns that don't roll up and don't provide the insights they need to grow and become more intelligent on how they deliver communications. And of course, we'll share demos. You'll see the demo jam. There's really a lot of opportunities for our development, alumni relations, advancement as a whole to come in and really gain a deeper understanding. So I'm pumped. And one last announcement. I was asked last week if I wanted to host the event. So if you're not sick of this space today, you may be after June 9th. And I'm dusting off all my skills as a former class clown in my younger years to try to make it entertaining and keep you all engaged for the day. So thanks for the opportunity to share, Kristen.
And thank you so much, Doug. So now I'm going to share our top three tips to make the most out of your time at this event. So if you're attending this specific webinar, you probably have been thinking about or have already signed up for the Higher Education Summit next month, which is absolutely amazing. However, if you have not signed up yet, we'll put the link in the chat now. So my first tip before we really get into things is to go ahead and block out the time for the morning of June 9th in your calendar, just so you're not faced with any double bookings or anything like that the day of the event. So this event is broken down into a half day of amazing thought leaders, industry innovators, and amazing announcements. The agenda is broken down on the screen here, but I want to call special attention to the three opportunities where we see digital transformation episodes released. This will be your time to find the customer sessions divided into the five tracks. So those tracks are recruiting and admissions, platform innovation, student success, alumni and advancement, and marketing engagement. So this will be your opportunity to see the power of the education cloud, the community cloud, the marketing cloud, and all the other Salesforce products in action. To maximize your time, our events are broken down into one for pre-higher ed summit, one for during the event, and one for after the event has ended. So tip number one, take advantage of this being a completely free virtual event. So that means ask faculty from other departments to join the event and attend sessions in different tracks other than yours. You can also invite more people from your team to gain a different perspective of each session. You may also want to predetermine team roles at the event. So maybe you have one team member there to attend sessions on alumni engagement, and another one is there to check out the demo jam, and another one is there to find out how other institutions are using Marketing Cloud. We also encourage you to invite all of your colleagues across campus. Other departments can also really benefit from all the features that Salesforce has to offer. So during the event, you're going to want to make sure you're interacting as much as possible. It's incredibly rare that we get to see so many of our peers, industry leaders, and subject matter experts all in one spot. And Salesforce.org has made a ton of investments to make sure this event is perfect and provides a great user experience for all attendees. So that being said, don't be afraid to ask questions and network and interact with your peers in the chat. One thing that I feel like we've all experienced in the shift to virtual working and virtual events is making sure that we also limit our distractions. So if you need to, close the door to your office, bedroom, or wherever you're watching from. And if the option is available, make sure to turn on your camera so you have face-to-face time with your peers in the industry. So after the event has ended, you're going to want to keep the momentum going. This means meeting up with your team and other departments who attended the event afterwards to knowledge share and brainstorm ways that you can implement all of the best practices that you saw into your own institution. You can also follow Cloud for Good, Salesforce, and all of the other speakers on LinkedIn and Twitter to keep the conversation going. You can also sign up for Trailhead, which is a gamified approach to learning Salesforce, and it'll help you learn about the products that you just heard about in a much more technical way. There's even a brand new recruiting and admissions module that was just released, and we'll send that out in the chat so you guys can check that out. And don't forget, you always have your Salesforce AE to reach out to with all of your questions. So we did ask our audience to submit some questions during the registration process. So we're going to start with those. But if you have any other questions, I encourage you to submit them using the Q&A button on your screen. And if you think of questions afterwards, you can always ask your AEs after this event is over. So Kristen, can you tell us more about how this will be different than a regular webinar or virtual meeting?
Yeah, absolutely. I think the collaboration is what's really, really going to be key here. So right now, you know, we're talking kind of at you guys and presenting slides. I expect this to be a much more interactive event with being able to raise hands, stop the presentation, talk to the presenters after the sessions. And like Doug mentioned, you know, being able to have that virtual booth experience to go out and see some of the products from the AppExchange partners, that's going to be really interesting. And it's not going to be single threaded, right? There are going to be multiple tracks running at the same time, multiple presentations. So it's going to be more like, imagine like we have a lobby here and you're going to be able to go into the rooms and go into the different sessions. I've only been able to see the presentation platform once so far, but Doug, did I miss anything?
No, you hit it exactly on the head, and we haven't shared a whole lot yet. Some of it's still in development, but it is going to be an immersive experience where you choose your own adventure. As the host, we'll call you back when our keynotes, Trevor is and Ariana are presenting, so you don't miss that. But you do get to kind of go off and have some really exciting, immersive one-on-one experiences upon your choosing. So it's a completely different environment. I've never seen anything like it.
So Doug, while I have you, do you know if the sessions are going to be recorded for people to watch later?
They are. They will be recorded and released. But I think the live engagement, if you're thinking, well, maybe I listen to them post-event, I highly encourage you to come live and engage. And I think the session recordings are one thing, but really, the opportunity to connect again one-on-one, even with your peers, right? There's a chat feature and you can chat with folks that maybe you know or would like to know. So the live event is going to bring a lot, but those sessions, the ones I mentioned, those will be recorded. So perhaps you can share them with peers afterwards.
Awesome. Jim, we got a question for you. So I'm not on the Education Cloud yet. Can I get a demo to play around before the Higher Ed Summit?
Yeah, you can. But you, remember, the biggest value of Salesforce is that you can. If you are new to Salesforce, just know that just because you can't see something doesn't mean it's not there. So go ahead and reach out to your AE and like myself, and we can help get you set up with that.
Awesome, thank you. So I can take this question. I've never been to the Higher Ed Summit before. What are the sessions like? So as mentioned earlier, they're all going to be like customer-led and highly engaging with all of the features in this platform. And it's really a place that you get to hear from your peers directly, which is awesome. Then Doug, I have another question for you. I have an interest in additional areas like executive education. How might I navigate?
Yeah, that's a great question. And I kind of alluded to it earlier. Well, I have friends or, you know, clients of ours who come to the events and they intentionally don't go to sessions that are just for their solution or their use case. They like to seek out, hey, what's Georgetown doing with MuleSoft? And that applies specifically to alumni data, but it might apply in a exec ed or professional learning environment to pull in your partners on campus, right? So There's something for everything or for everyone, particularly when we look at engagement, right? That's another one that has wide application. So so we have a lot of trails this year. We have the opportunity to really go deep on those areas, but I encourage you to go venture out and listen to new sessions that maybe aren't necessarily totally aligned with what you do today or are looking to do.
Awesome. And then Kristen, you mentioned that you've been to a lot of the higher ed summits. What's been your favorite part out of all of them?
My favorite part is actually social media. I'm not a big Twitter user. Like normally it's not something I check in the evenings, but I feel like when I'm at these events, like as I'm sitting in a keynote, usually I have Twitter up and I feel that the content that people are sharing about what they just heard and what that meant to them sometimes is more impactful to me than just hearing it single threaded. So I have all of my, you know, the community people that I follow on Twitter, and I really like using the hashtags for the events and following those people and kind of playing along with what they're hearing and what it means to them as well.
Can I add something, Taylor?
Yeah, definitely.
So, we talked about the community awards. That's something that we added, I think in Austin was likely the first year, and it's grown. It's tremendous. I mean, it's like a mini Oscars, right? You'll see the recap of the individuals and the organizations. I actually get to present a few of those, and I'm most excited about the community champion. Last year, Joanne Iturbe, who will be joining me to present that award. And we have three remarkable candidates. Kaylee Gould, who was on the slide earlier, Florence Pardoni and Kathy Lukeman, who I mentioned, are three finalists. And I got to be honest, it's a difficult choice. All three have added so much to our community. So expect some emotion there when that is announced live, and you'll get to see who wins that award. That's really the only individual award. So those are fantastic. Really, really must see.
That's awesome. I'm super excited to tune in and see that. But all right, I think that's all for today. Thank you so much for joining this webinar, to everyone who joined. And thank you, Doug, Jim, and Kristen, for sharing all of your knowledge. It was absolutely fantastic. If you have any additional questions, please reach out to your Salesforce and CloudForGood AEs for additional assistance. Because of everyone's support today, we can continue having these amazing webinars. In fact, we have a webinar tomorrow all about executive education at the Higher Education Summit. So we hope to see you and all of your colleagues there. Also, look out for an email from our marketing director to hear more about our upcoming webinars. Thank you. Have a great rest of the week.
Take care. Bye.